First part, positive work. Do an example. There is an object, say a suitcase. You move the suitcase, apply a force, the person applies force in upward direction. And you shift this suitcase to a new position. Weight of the object is downward. Force applied by the person is upwards. And displacement of the object is also upwards. As per definition, work is equal to force. Work done by what? Work done by applied force. Work done by the man. Work done by the man is equal to force applied by the man into S. This is force applied by the person is upward, S. And what is the angle between the two? Applied force upward. Displacement upwards. Angle between the two? Zero. Cos 0. This is positive. S is also positive because it represents what? Magnitude of F. Magnitude of S has to be positive. Cos 0 is also positive. So work done by the man is positive. So work will be positive when? Work is positive when theta lies between 0 and 90. If theta is greater than 0 or equal to 0, even if it is equal to 0, cos 0 is what? 1. When theta is equal to 90, cos 90 is 0. That is why it is not equal to 90, it is less than 90. Correction in notes is required. Time with you is 3 minutes. 3 minutes to write positive work. B part, negative work. This is the applied force. Gravitational force Fg acts downward. Its magnitude is equal to mg. So work done by gravity. Gravitational force acts downwards. Displacement of the particle S upwards. Angle between the two is 180 degree. It is F gravity dot S. Magnitude of gravitational force, magnitude of displacement, cos of angle between the two, 180. Cos 180 is what? Minus 1. This is positive. This is also positive because it is magnitude. But this cos 180 is what? Negative. So it is negative. Work is negative when theta lies between 90 and 180. If theta is equal to 90 degree, cos 90 is 0. That is why equal to not is acceptable. But when theta is equal to 180, cos 180 is minus 1. 2 minutes to write. Circular motion. One of the example where the work is zero is circular motion. When you say work is equal to F into S into cos theta, either F is zero, then work is zero. If displacement of the particle is zero, even then work is zero. For example, there is a wall. You push a wall, you are applying a force, but the displacement of the wall is zero, work done is zero. Third possibility, that this parameter is zero. Cos theta is zero when theta is equal to 90 degree. Example is sun, earth moves around sun because gravitational force provides necessary centripetal force. If there is a positive charge, nucleus, electron moves around the nucleus because this electromagnetic force provides necessary centripetal force. As this particle moves from this position to a new position, very close, displacement S, F and S are inclined to each other at what angle? 90 degree. So it is equal to F S cos 90. Cos 90 is what? 0. F S 0. So work done is 0. Work is 0. F theta is equal to what? 90. 2 minutes with you to write. 2 minutes to write. Numerical number 2. Question is, a body of mass 0.3 kg is taken up an inclined plane of length 10 meter and height 5 meter and then allowed to slide down to the bottom again. The coefficient of friction between the body and the plane is 0.15. What is A part? Work done by gravitational force over the round trip. Underline round trip, A part. B part, work done by the applied force on the upward journey. C, work done by the frictional force over the round trip. And D part, kinetic energy of the body at the end of the trip. Try A part, time is 2 minutes. Yes, inclined plane of length. Yes. What is the total length of the plane? 10 meter. What is the height? 5 meters. Let this angle be theta. From the triangle, sine theta is equal to what? Height that is perpendicular by hypotenuse. 5 by 10. Is equal to 1 by 2. Theta is equal to what? 30 degrees. So, wherever I need, I will use theta is equal to 30 degrees. A part, work done in round trip is equal to F dot S for round trip. Round trip, you start from here, move to the top position, come back. What is the displacement? 0. One method. Second method. The object is here. You move from this position, gain a height h. When you move, then what work done by gravity in up journey plus work done by gravity. This is method 2. This is method 1. Work done in up journey, work done in down journey. Work done in up journey by gravity. Suppose mgh minus. If this work is taken as minus, then when it is moving down, that work is equal to plus. If one work is plus, the other is negative. Answer is 0. 1 minute to complete. Round trip. The stress word was round trip. B part. Yes, work done by applied force for upward journey. Why you need to apply force? When you move it in the upward direction, how much force I need to apply? That is what the question is. Weight of the object is how much? Yes, mg. As per the formula, mg. No doubt it is 3 kg. This component is mg cos theta. This component is mg sin theta. How much force you need to apply? Force applied to move upward is mg sin theta if friction is not there. Go through the question, friction is there or not? Friction is there. It is not a smooth surface. That is why when you try to move it upwards, friction will oppose it. So applied force is required for two purposes. Number one, mg sin theta. Number two, for friction. So work done by applied force is equal to applied force into displacement. Into applied force is along this line, displacement is also along the same line. Displacement is also along the same line. Angle between the two, these two, is 0. So it is applied force S cos 0, which is 1. Applied force is equal to what? Yes, mg sin theta plus frictional force into S into 1. Cos 0 is 1. It is two parts now. Mg sin theta into S plus friction. Yes, how much is friction? Friction is F is equal to nu times R. R is equal to what? Mg cos theta into S. 3 minutes with you to solve these two parts separately. What is the answer to this part? One. What is the answer to this part? What is the answer to the first part? No. 9.8. Take G to be 9.8. M is equal to what? 0.3 kg. G is 9.8. Sin theta is 1 by 2. S is 10. Yes, 14.7 joule plus. The other part comes out to be, say, if you don't have the calculation, let me write it. 3.8. We'll save time. You can have calculation at home. total comes out to be what? Yes? 18.5. Total is 18.5 joule. Now, yes, focus here. This part corresponds to work done against gravity. This part corresponds to work done against friction. This is not recoverable. Work done against gravity gets stored in form of gravitational potential energy. You release it, you can get it back. But this is work done, this second part is work done against friction. That is why C part leaves with what? Work done by friction in round trip. Am I right? When you move up, there is work done against friction. When you move down, there is work done against friction. In both the cases, there is a work done against friction. C part. Work done against by friction, work done by friction is equal to work done by friction in up journey plus work done by friction in down journey. Both cases, yes. When the object moves upwards, friction is downwards. Angle between the two is 180. When the object moves downwards, friction is upwards. Again, the angle is 180. That is why for both the cases, this value is same 3.8, but it is minus 3.8 plus minus 3.8. Total is equal to what? Yes, 7.6. Tell the answer, please. 7.6 joule. D part. Yes. What is the kinetic energy of the object as it moves down? Let me call this position as A. It reaches to a position B. This height is H. We want to find out VB. D part. What is the potential energy of the object here? MGH. As it moves down, in case there is no friction, then when the object reaches this position, kinetic energy of the object will remain same. Whatever is the potential energy here, MGH, same is the kinetic energy at this point in case there is no friction. But in this case there is friction. So kinetic energy will come out to what? Kinetic energy at B will be equal to what? Potential energy at A minus loss. Loss of energy due to friction. What was energy at A? MGH. What is the loss due to friction? 3.8. M is how much? 0.3. G is 9.8. H is 5 minus 3.8 is equal to. Solve this. Solve this and come out with the answer. Take one second. Yes. How much? This is how much first part? 14.3.8. Total? 10.92. Tell the answer.
10.9.